Sit on bus one Friday to sun.
Woo!
Sarara bus.
Before beginning off the college tour of University of Maryland, Baltimore County, I'd like to add on a few informations. So currently UMBC has 14,000 students. It was ranked one among the top six most innovative universities. It has its name among the top 100 public institutions in the federal research support. A bit about my introduction. I'm Chetan Desai. This is my channel. That's The Ideas Can Travel. So I graduated with a degree of MPS in data science from this college. Thanks for all the views for the previous videos. I'm back with another video. This time it's my college, that is University of Maryland, Baltimore County, college tour.
So this is the Hilltop Circle.
So these are the shuttles. The police stations, which is located right on campus, and then if you can see that big building over there, it's a library. So we are just heading to the parking lot.
Just show your ID cards and you are allowed to go there.
So that's the Hilltop Circle, and then if you walk past straight, these are the hostels, and this would be the dining sections. Some of the other options for food on campus are most of them in commons, such as the Dunkin', and also they have Starbucks, Chick-fil-A, and a lot of other restaurants. The food in toilets are really good. So on Thursdays and Fridays, if you are a grad student, you would get the meal for around $6, so which is worth it. So if you are here on campus, so you can just opt for a meal option. So yeah, check that out if you are on campus, and do give that a try.
So this is the map of UMBC. We are currently here, so we are running to this Alban Library Gallery, and I'll be heading towards the tennis courts, to the rack, the pool.
So I'm heading towards the library now. So the building over here, heading right next from the Turbits, you would come across the public policy building. And if you walk past straight, if you see a bigger building over there, that's the library. Students even tend to play cricket, football, soccer, and a lot more in this section. So currently, it's very humid in the end week of May. So that's the reason it's too hot. If not, this place would be too cold. So yeah, if you are a fun-loving person, coming out and playing a bigger would make your day. This is the Alban Okun Library.
The library timings are from 9 in the morning until 10 in the evenings. And also there's a library which is located in the downstairs, which is open 24/7.
The library would personally be my best to-go places, you know, to prepare yourself for the internals, for your exams, to take interviews, and for this one of the spectacular view of the downtown, and so on.
then see, this is the Starbucks and Chick-fil-A right inside this building. Currently this is closed for the summer days. It'll be open again. After the summer break, Chick-fil-A was one of my first places to work at as a food service worker. So I worked there for almost a month, working on multiple different roles, over the counters, handling the customers, and giving out the changes, making fries, and also making friends. So yeah. That was one of my memorable days.
I also worked as a Global Ambassador peer mentor on campus, which provided me with an opportunity to help introduce incoming international students to campus, resources, people, and department within the universities, facilitate the academic and the social integration of incoming international students to the culture of UMBC, and also to plan, coordinate, participate in all the events for students along side other ambassadors in answering prospective students' queries.
So I'll show you my classrooms. So these are the classrooms. So yeah, 1x1 was my classroom. So this is how classroom looks like.
I was also the teaching assistant for the Department of Data Science for 2 semesters on campus.
These are the multi-courts, so you can play basketball, you can play soccer, and also you can play tennis, and also badminton. So this is the indoor track, and also the multiple courts here for volleyballs, for basketballs, and so on. Yeah, so that's the functional fitness training room. So this is the yoga room, the fitness, and we have 3 multiple courts here.
No, I have to go to the college room.
Walk right side after exiting the rack, you'll enter the swimming pool section, which is outdoor. Guys, this is
there's also a cinema hall located inside the campus. They show movies,
I guess one or two movies in a month, which is usually conducted by the UMBC SCP. So check out that, guys, it's so fun. I have attended a couple of movies, and they also like provide you with free popcorns and drinks, so it's interesting. I'm here on the tennis courts. So I was the tennis instructor for UMBC Summer Camp 2021. So these were the courts which use them to teach kids. So it's a wonderful place to be at. So they have pretty good courts. They are good in condition, so they have 3+2+1 tennis courts. I was also the secretary of the club tennis team which we had here in UMBC. We played a couple of tournaments, and I was also playing for one of the local clubs here in the USTA. This is the pathway. So the softball and the baseball fields from this point are not accessible, so these are the outdoor and tracks. And these are also the multiple courts used for lacrosse, soccer, football. And finally, after this wonderful a year and a half tenure of mine comes to an end with my graduation ceremony.
In 1986, she is followed by the graduates of Marshall, Dr. Jeffrey Halverson, Associate Dean of the Graduate School. He is joined by Staff Marshals Mr. Damian Doyle, the 2021 recipient of the Presidential Distinguished Staff Award for Professional Staff, and Deputy CIO and Senior Associate Vice President of Information and Technology. And Ms. Teresa White, the 2021 recipient of the Presidential Distinguished Staff Award for non-exempt.
All my friends, my roommates, and my professors here helped me throughout the journey. So I'm a lot different person now after the graduation. So I wish all of the very best to the incoming students. I know you would have ample amount of opportunities. I was also a part of graduate student representative for the athletics department here in UMBC. So this was the first time we organized a cricket tournament, which was a part of intramural cricket. I would like to say that just keep believing in your dreams, just keep focusing and working hard. The only competition is yourself. So do let me know if you need any help regarding anything. So you can find my LinkedIn in the description.
and also in my channel description. So all the best, and see you at the next video.